Welcome all my MAPC students and the academic counselors in RC Cochin. You must be all doing well and enjoying the learning experience while pursuing the master's program in psychology from IGNOU. And I hope that you are keeping fine and safe during this challenging times during the pandemic situation. The regional center and the study centers are trying to take up this challenge, and they're helping the students in the learner support services. In this session, I will just present an overview of the MA practical guidelines that have come up during it's a standby arrangement during this time. By this time, you must have received the material, and if not, then you can please access the soft copy of the material of all the theory as well as the practical that is uploaded on www.ignou.ac.in eGyankosh. You can just go onto the website and access the soft copy of the material. As you are aware that we have practicals in MA1 and MA2, and these are the lab-based, this is the lab-based course actually. But during this pandemic, we have come up with certain guidelines with regard to practical, internship as well as project, keeping in mind the situation that is prevailing across the country. So this is just a standby arrangement, and but for this also it is very important that you read the handbook on practical before taking up these activities. So handbook on practicum, that is MPCL 007 in the first year, as well as MPCE 014, 024, and 034 for the MA second year. First I will be discussing about the first year guidelines, and then it will be followed by the second year guidelines. So if you have seen, because the guidelines that are uploaded on ignou.ac.in, then on the home page you go to About Us, School of Studies. School of Studies, we go to School of Social Sciences. Then under the programs, we go to MAPC, and in the MAPC section, we have all the guidelines, the latest guidelines that we have uploaded in January 2021. Related to practical course, related to internship as well as your project. The internship and project is as per the specialization, and the practical is MA first year, it is common, while as for the second year, it is as per the specialization group that you have opted. So these guidelines, start of it, I will just tell that these guidelines were there for the learners who had written their exam in June 2020, which were conducted in September-October 2020, and then we came up with these guidelines again because we have to take special permission for the online conduction and for this term and exam also. This is applicable for the students who are writing or will be appearing in the Viva for the December 2020 and as well as June 2021. Now, you just need to ensure that you have completed 1 year of cycle, and similarly, you have re-registered for the program. So at the outset, I would just like to mention here, first of all, you please read the practicum handbook, as well as the present guidelines before really taking up the activity. So here what we have done is we have listed some tests and activities. We have uploaded some videos. They're followed by some questions. So if you see the activities that we have listed, there are 6 activities for the MA first year. There are certain tests also. So test also, like for example, what we do in the lab setting, it is the tests are, of course, they're paper pencil. We do it on each other. Then in the exam, we do it on some participant, and then we write a report. Here, what is happening is these are online tests available, and you have to administer it on yourself. You have to just do it yourself, or your friend or acquaintance or your family member, right? The one thing that the commonality between this as well as the previous, the lab based, is that, like for example, every test is based on some theory or some model, so you should be aware of that model. And since this you have done online, so you need to adapt it. That is why I'm just saying that you need to read the handbook so that you get an idea of how to write a practical, how to write a test right? So like, for example, we have the name of the test, then we material required. Of course, here it will, since it's a computer based, so you will be writing accordingly, a computer or internet connection and a paper and a pencil, so on. So accordingly, you can adapt it. The results you will get it while you do it. If the results you will get, like for example, you go to the next page and the interpretation is done. So accordingly, you can take a printout and or so not a printout, you can take a screenshot or you can just copy it and attach it in your document that you're going to submit. I'll come on to that later. So this is as far as the test is concerned. Then we have certain activities also, like for example, we have given a video link or an you need to read an article and then you have to answer some questions. So just try, these are actually what we have done is these are all open-ended reflective exercises. You have to do it on your own, right? Of course, we have like one or two sessions will be conducted because the academic counselor will help you in mentoring you. But these are very self-explanatory exercises that you can attempt on your own also. That is one thing. So try, I would rather say, like if you go to your class and you read the guidelines, try attempting the exercises and then go to the class and then you can clarify your doubts. It's up to you, of course. It's a open-ended exercise. And if you want to attempt it after, you know, after the sessions, that is also fine. Then whenever the sessions are there, please try to attend them. They are mandatory, of course, because you'll get a fair idea of for those students who are, you know, they have some doubts or clarification to be clarified. So it is suggested that you attend the sessions because it will be really helpful. And then you have to make a file. You have to make a file accordingly because I'm getting emails that whether we have to write it down or we have to type it. Now, since you are doing it online, I think you can also type it. Otherwise, if you do it handwritten, then you have to scan it and you have to upload it, right? Here, already when you are typing it, it is up to you. It's not that hard and fast rule that you have to type it. It has to be handwritten. Like for assignments, assignments have to be handwritten. They are not typed. So here we have given the flexibility. Like in project, you do it. It's typed. In internship also, most of you are doing it in a typed format. So here also the option is yours. Either it can be typed, it can be handwritten also. And because you have to upload it finally for evaluation to whatever link that the RC provides you. So you have to upload it finally. Then when we compare it with the lab based, what it was in practice, I mean, it was before the pandemic situation, in the exam, in the term end exam, you had the conduction part also and the viva voce. But here what is, because there is no conduction, right? So this, what you will do is like whatever the file you have made, it will be uploaded for evaluation. And then in the final exam, that is a term end exam, only the viva voce will be there depending on what you have done. Now, there might be students who have already, you know, before the pandemic situation, before the lockdown, students have completed their lab work. So that will not, that attempt will not go futile. And you submit, like for example, for the students who have done the lab work, they can submit their files, provided, you know, that you have done the lab work. You have got it evaluated by your academic counselor and you can then upload the file. Your viva will be based on what work you have done in the lab. So this is for the online activities. For them, for such learners, the viva will be based on what they have done, right? But overall, I would also suggest that you read the practical handbook also, because it gives an overview of what is to be done, right? Like for example, if it was a lab setting, though it is not, but then you get an idea of what is a test, what is an experiment, types of tests and so on. So you get a fair idea of how to go about the tests and you know, different activities. So if I just to summarize it, we have six activities in the MA first year. First is about, and all these activities, they have been picked according to the theory courses that you have done, like from MPC 1 to 6. You have MPC 1, cognitive psychology, then developmental psychology, you have social psychology, personality, right? So these four mainly, because the next one is the statistics and research methods. So the primarily from MPC 1 to 4, we have actually selected some activities depending upon these courses. It is not necessarily that they had to match with what we had given in the handbook in the lab-based course. So first is upon the, this is from a learning theory. This is the Bobo doll experiment that we have given. It is, you have to watch the video. It is followed by three questions. Then we have given reference to Howard Gardner's blog also, and accordingly you have to write. See, now if you see, they're all open-ended, right? So, and they're reflective exercises that you can do it on your own also. Then you have to interview an older adult. Now, this is from developmental perspective, and you have to understand the process of aging, and you can formulate, you can frame your own questions accordingly, and for this you can always take help of your academic counselor. Then we have a test on locus of control, and then we have cattle 16 PF, right? And we have it, locus of control is also, there is a theory on it, and then you have cattle 16 PF, we have the cattle's theory on personality. You have your text, that is the study material, but apart from this, if you feel like, you can always refer to the extra reading material that is available online, provided you access the authentic websites. You know, you have to be careful, like it has to be some government website or .edu, that is from the academic institutions and so on. So it just be cautious of from where you are taking down the information. It should connect it with your study material, because some theory is being asked, outline the theory of motivation that you think deals with such social comparison at organizational level. So this means that you also need to connect with your SLM. That is 031, 032 and 033 actually. So whichever part you think where theory of motivation is given, you need to connect to that. And then the remedies that you would suggest to motivate the client to reduce such perceived inequity. So here, again, you see it's so reflective and it's open-ended. You need to think upon it and then you write it in your own words. Evaluation is similar. We have 50-50 criteria. So 50 is internal evaluation and 50 will be your term and exam, viva voce. It is given very clearly in the guidelines. We have actually clubbed the guidelines for the student as well as the academic counselor, so that there is, you know, there are not too many guidelines on the website, so that, you know, we all get confused. And this is applicable for all our learners for who are writing their exam in December 2020 and June 2021. So with this, I hope that the things will be clear, and after this also, when you attempt the exercises, you can clarify more with your academic counselor. Try to connect with your academic counselor and clarify your doubts. Our emails are all from where you are taking down the information. It should not be copied verbatim. Try to paraphrase it and put it in your own words. And in the end, you can always, that would be very interesting if you can put the references, even the online referencing. There is a style of present, you know, writing the references that you refer to, I mean, that you have to follow, the APA style. So if you are referring to books offline, if you're referring to books online or to journal articles and so on, you can very well give the referencing style with the references in APA style. And because this will also be very helpful from the Viva point of view, right? So the examiner will also get a fair idea that you have, you know, referred to so many journal articles or books, and that activity is also clear to you. So if you see, we have also given you a methodology in the guidelines where it is very well highlighted what is what. Like, for example, we have the internal evaluation, we have the external evaluation, and in external evaluation, we just have the viva voce, that is the term and examination. So after you complete all the activities, your file is evaluated and it is uploaded, and then after uploading, it will be evaluated, and then it will be, there will be a viva voce. So this is for your MA first year. And then when we come on to the MA second year practical guidelines, this is as per your specialization group. Now, we have given, like, for example, just for the first year students also, like 15 to 20 pages. It can vary, like it can be lessened also, it can be 15 or 20, whatever. It is up to you, but it should not be, you know, too small, you know, it should be self-explanatory. Then when we come on to the second year guidelines, the overall the how we are going to present and write and so on remains the same, like what we are doing it in MA first year. Here also we have listed few activities depending upon the specialization groups, like the clinical psychology, counseling psychology, industrial and organizational psychology. So if I take up the first group, that is group A, that is clinical psychology, we have the big five personality test. Now these are all open access tests that we have given, so there's no problem of, you know, using it, but it should not be for commercial purpose. It is just for your educational purpose. So keeping in mind that perspective, we have given you all these tests. So we have the big five personality test, which is of course based on the big five model. You can always refer to the model, and it is also given in your SLM also. And then you have to administer the test, you get the results, you have to interpret it accordingly, and either you do it on yourself, someone from your family member, your friend or acquaintance, whatever. Then the second activity is on the Rorschach test, Rorschach-Inglot test, and it's a 5 minute video clip that you have to see, and then accordingly certain you know, contents, something is asked on this, right? You have to answer accordingly. You can take help from your study material, you can always take help from your you know, extra reading material that is available offline or online, or your, if depending what is the current situation in your place, whether you can go to some library and so on. It's up to you, it's not hard and fast, but of course, because now most of us have internet access, so online resources are very handy in this case. So just ensure that you don't copy anything verbatim. That is very important. So in this also, in this video clip, after seeing this, read the content and watch the video clip carefully. Summarize the content in your own words and reflect on a case where it can be used as a standalone test, or it can be used with other tests to diagnose the symptoms. So that you can give an example, and or depending upon a case study, that is one thing. Then the third exercise is about about DSM-5. What is the shift from DSM-4 TR to DSM-5, right? As you must be knowing that DSM-5 recently was published, not recently, it's been some time, in 2013. So you just have to make out some differences with the help of online offline resources, so that you can you have to make a summary out of it. So for this also the counselor will help you. So this is now many resources are available online. Then we have given you a National Mental Health Survey of India that was conducted in 15-16. This report is there, and there is a special chapter that is devoted to mental disorders. You need to summarize the content and organize it coherently. What do you understand by that particular? Because, you know, mental health surveys have not been conducted so often post-independence, and this one is an important survey. So from, you know, as you are specializing in clinical psychology area, so this becomes very important. So just read the survey, and especially that chapter, which is particularly devoted to mental disorders. Then there is a case study we have given, and it is followed by two questions. So you have to read the case study and reflect, like, what is there in the your study material, and then you need to answer the questions. Accordingly, you will have to make a report and submit it for evaluation, and then it will be followed by your final term and exam, that is your Viva VOC. When we come on to the group B, counseling psychology, here again big five has been repeated, because, you know, the students are going to be different, but the tests can be similar if that is a part of your SLM. And here also we again have given big five personality tests. This is an important model actually right now. And then we have given you two video links that has been prepared by NIMHANS. This is on mobile internet addiction, and the first video is of course for 4 minutes, but the second one is little lengthy. So, but then you watch the videos carefully, and then try attempting the questions that are followed. There are four questions and they you need to answer, like, for example, is internet disorder identified as a separate disorder? So you will also get the answers to these questions in those videos also. So you need to watch them carefully. So what are the different names given to internet addiction? Identify the probable causes, as well as if you are placed as a school counselor, you need to devise a plan for parents of the school children and so on. So this is kind of also an open-ended exercise where you will, of course, you will enjoy doing it also. This is something different from a typical, you know, routine lab-based work. So here, because you, for the students who are specializing in counseling psychology, for them also, it is also very important to know about DSM-5 criteria that came out in 2013. So accordingly, this is the question again. You'll have to identify the differences between DSM-4 TR and DSM-5, and then you have to summarize the key points. Then we have given you a case history. Like, case history is there in your handbook. So here also, again, the suggestion is to read your handbook on practicum, that is 014, 024 and 034 carefully, plus this online guidelines, practical activity guidelines. This activity actually is given in your handbook, page number 10. So accordingly, how you you conduct a case history and you take the important information, and then accordingly you write in that, in the sequence or in the order as it is given in the handbook. So this here, your handbook on practicum will be very helpful. So you have to read the case history method properly. Then again, in the fifth activity, we have given you a case study that is related to counseling only, and which is followed by two questions, and how you are going to counsel the client and how you will go about, you need to reflect on that. And in similar way, like in the first group, you are also going to write these activities. This will be uploaded for evaluation by, and this will be, of course, evaluated by your academic counselor, followed by Viva Voce. Then the last group, when it comes to the last group, it is industrial and organizational psychology. Here again, we have repeated this test, the Big Five personality test, because it is important for all of us, irrespective of any specialization group. Accordingly, you attempt the online version, and then you interpret and discuss the results that you get. Then we have a life value inventory. This is an online scale actually, and where you need to, as actually there are instructions, you just need to follow them, and you have to accordingly, you will have to complete the test online. You get the results immediately, then you can accordingly interpret. So this is also an interesting, actually, this is an interesting scale, which is open, from open resource, which can be used for research and education purpose. And that is why it has been added in this activity. Then the third activity is, of course, the conflict management style. Again, it's a very interesting activity where you need to score, you have to attempt it and then score and interpret and discuss the results accordingly. So these are the tests. Of course, there is the fourth test also in industrial organizational group. We have given actually four tests and one case study. So for these are like, for example, in the offline mode, we used to do the paper pencil test. So here now these are computer based tests in a way, CBT. So then we are also most often, many of us are using this particular scale, perceived stress scale by Cohen, in our dissertations also. So this is also an open resource scale, and this you need to attempt and then accordingly score. Then you get the results, you need to interpret and discuss accordingly. So this is also a very interesting scale. The last activity in this is a case study again, and in this case study, it is followed by again two questions. You read the case properly, and then you try to interpret about what is the client's problem, and then you try to attempt the while answering the questions.